Hi students, welcome to VTeach. VTeach is the India's first learning platform especially designed for BTech students. On our platform, we provide training for campus recruitment and we provide separate modules for TCS, Wipro, Infosys, Capgemini, etc. In this video, I am going to solve aptitude questions from TCS and NQT previous papers. In the subsequent videos, I will teach you the entire syllabus from the basics. Please subscribe to our channel. Find the greatest number that will divide 148, 246 and 623, leaving the remainders 4, 6, 1 respectively. So out of these numbers, if we divide the each number by a particular number, we have to that find out the number. So out of these three numbers, one number will divide each and every number, that is the highest or greatest number, which divides these three numbers exactly but leaves the remainder 4, 6, 1. That means some number is there x. I am dividing 148 with x. I am getting the remainder 4. Similarly, if I divide the number x with 246, I will get the remainder as 6. If I divide a number 260, if I divide 623 with x, I will get the remainder 11. So what does it mean? If I subtract 148 with 4, then what will be the remainder? Exactly 0, no? Because the extra 4 will be subtracted from this dividend. So then the divisor will leave the remainder 0. Okay? Now what I am doing? 148 minus 4, that is nothing but 144. Next, from 246, if I subtract this 6, then what will be our remainder? Exactly this x will divide that number and leaves the remainder 0. So 246 minus 6 will be 240. Next, 6, similarly 623, if I subtract this 11 from 623, I will get the exact number which will be divided by x. That is 216, 612. Okay. So when I divide this all number, that is the highest common number which divides this number, now the remainder will be 0. Now in that case, what can we use? We can just simply find out the HCF of those numbers. So now let us see, for 144 we can write it as 12 into 12. That means 12 into 12 can be written as 2 into 6, 6 can be written as 3 into 2. Again, for another 12, 2 into 3 into 2. Okay. Now for 240, if you cannot write like this, simply take the LCM. 2 times 120, 2 times 60, 2 times 30, 2 times 15, 15 in 3 table 5 times. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. This I am writing again, 2 into 3 into. Okay, similarly 612, take the LCM of 612, 2 times 306, again in 2 table is 153, again in 3 table 51 times, in 13 table this is nothing but 7 times, again 51 in 3 table we will get total, this is 17 times, so that is nothing but 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 17. Highest common factor means the number which is common in each and everything. All the three numbers. So 2 into, that is nothing but HCF is equal to 2 into. Here also we are having one 2 pair. So 2 into 3, 3, 3, 3. And no other numbers are common in all of the three. So HCF will be 4 threes are 12. So option B is correct. So the number which divides exactly these three numbers leaving remainders 4, 6 and 11 is nothing but 12. See the next question. A mother, her little daughter and her just born infant boy together stood on a weighing machine which shows 74 kgs. How much does the daughter weigh if the mother weighs 46 more than the combined weight of daughter and the infant? And the infant weight 60% less than the daughter. So while reading question, you can understand the total weight of the mother and the infant, and individual weights of them both are revolving around the daughter's weight itself. Okay, because see here, mother's weight is combined weight of daughter and the infant. Infant weight is 60% less than the daughter. Both weights are revolving around the daughter's weights only. So it is dependent on the daughter's weight. So I am letting the daughter's weight be X. Okay. Now see the first thing which they have given. A mother, her little daughter, her just born boy stood on weighing station who weighed 74 kgs. Before going into that, let us see the infant weight also. What is the infant weight they given? It is 60% less than the daughter. In 100%, 60% less means it is nothing but 40%. Okay. So 40% means 40 by 100. That is nothing but 0.4. 40% means 0.4. So 40% less than the daughter. That is 40% into. So 60% less than the daughter means 40% into X. X is nothing but daughter's weight. So what is 40%? That is nothing but 0.4 and X. So 0.4 into X is nothing but the infant weight. Now let us see the first condition they given. Both all the mother weight, daughter weight and the infant weight is 74 kgs. Okay. So we don't know the mother weight. And they given another condition that if the mother weighs 46 more than the combined weight of daughter and infant. So mother weight is equal to 46 more. More given means you should do addition. If they given less means you should subtract. So 46 more than daughter and infant weight. What is the daughter weight? X. What is the infant weight? 0.4x. So mother's weight is 46 plus x plus 0.4. That is nothing but 46 plus 1.4x is our mother's weight. Now substitute this mother's weight, infant weight and daughter's weight in this condition. What is the mother's weight? 46 plus 1.4x plus the daughter's weight is x plus the infant weight is 0.4x. That is nothing but equals to 74. 1.4 plus x plus 0.4. 1.4 plus x means 1, 0.4. We will get total 2.8. So 2.8x is equal to 74. Bring this 46 to the other side. 74 minus 46, that is nothing but equal to 2.8x is equals to 28. Okay. Now what is the value of x? 28 by 2.4. This is nothing but 1 times 10 times. That is, if we multiply 28 with 10, what we will get? Decimal will move one step right side and we will get 28. So x is 10. 10 means what is x? X is nothing but the daughter's weight. We have considered x as daughter's weight. So the daughter's weight is 10 kgs. That is what they have asked in the question. How much does the daughter weight? So the daughter's weight is simply 10 kgs. So option D is correct. See the next question here. Thomas takes 7 days to paint a house completely, whereas Raj would require 9 days to paint the same house completely. How many days will take to paint the house if both of them work together? Okay. So give the answer in the nearest integer. So if we have any decimal answer, we should round it off and we should find out the nearest answer in the options. The first thing what they gave, Thomas takes 7 days to paint a house. So he will, to complete the work totally, he will take 7 days. So his capacity to do the work in each day, that is in a single day, is 1 by 7. So 1 by 7th of the work he will do in one day. Next, Raj would require 9 days to paint the same house. So Raj takes 1 by 9th of the work he will complete in one day. So Raj takes 9 days to complete the work. In a single day, he can do 1 by 9th of the work. So in the question they ask, how many days will take to paint the house if both of them work together? That means simply add the individual capacities. 1 by 7 plus 1 by 9. That is the LCM is 7 into 963. Cross multiply the numerators with the denominators. 9 plus 7. That is nothing but 16 by 63 is the work which both can do in a single day. So if both are doing the work in a single day, they can do 16 by 63 part of the work. So how many days means simply just reciprocal the number, that is 63 by 16. So in 63 by 16 days, they can complete the work when they are doing it combinedly. 63 by 16 means it is nothing but simply 3.99, nearest to 4. So in total 4 days, they can both complete the work. So option A is correct. See the next question here. A bag contains 8 white balls and 3 blue balls. Another bag contains 7 white and 4 blue balls. What is the probability of getting the blue ball? So in a bag, totally they have given us 2 bags. So out of 2 bags, 1 bag contains 8 white balls and 3 blue balls. In the second bag, they have contained 7 white balls and 4 blue balls. So what is the probability of getting a blue ball? So in both the bags, we can select either one of the bag, and from that bag, we should pick one blue ball. So what is the chance that the ball will be of blue color? So first we need to write the probability for selecting the bag, because it is not a single bag. We have 2 different bags. So out of 2 different bags, we can select any one of the bag. So what is probability formula? Favorable events by total number of events. So what is the favorable event selecting only one single bag? So out of 2, we have to select only one. So 1 by total number of events, that is total number of bags is 2. So selecting the bag is 1 by 2. And from that bag, we have to select blue ball. Same formula for blue also, favorable events. So how many blue balls are there in first bag? Total 3 blue balls. So 3C1. Divided by total number of balls in first bag, that is 8 plus 3. This is for first bag. We can select either first or second, or we are getting here or no. So we have to take addition. So second bag, total number of balls are 7 plus 4. Out of them, how many blue balls are there? 4 blue balls. So 4C1. That is equals to 3C1 is nothing but 3 by 8 plus 3, 11 plus 4C1, it is nothing but 4 divided by 7 plus 4, that is also 11. So total how many? What is the answer here? 7 by 11. So from either of the bags, we can select the blue ball 7 by 11. But we have to multiply with the bag selection also, because 1 by 2 is the probability of bag selection. So the probability of getting a blue bag from either of the bags is equal to 1 by 2 into 7 by 11. That is 7 by 22 is our answer. That is option B is our answer. So see the next question here. Jake can dig a wall in 16 days. Paul can dig the same well in 24 days. Jake, Paul and Hari together dig the well in 8 days. Hari alone can dig in how many days? So first they have given Jake alone can dig in 16 days and Paul alone can dig in 24 days. Jake plus Paul plus Hari can dig it in 8 days. Now let us find out the work done by each of them in a single day. So totally they can complete the work in 16 days. So in a single day, they can complete 1 by 16th part of the work. That means Jake can do 1 by 16th part of the work in a single day. Paul can do it in 24 days. So Paul can do 1 by 24th part of the work in a single day. Similarly, Jack, Paul and Harry, 3 of them together can do the work in 8 days. So all the 3 of them can do 1 by 8th of the work in a single day. That is Jack plus Paul plus Hari's work. Now they are asked only to find out Hari alone can do the work in how many days. So I am taking Jack plus Paul plus Hari's work in one day is equal to 1 by 8. We know the individual work capacity done by them in a single day of Jake and Paul. Simply substitute those values. 1 by 16 plus 1 by 24 plus Hari's work is equal to 1 by 8. Now take these two fractions to the other side of the equality. That is, Hari's work is equal to 1 by 8 minus 1 by 16 minus 1 by 24. Hari is equals to, take LCM of 8, 16, 24. LCM will be, in two table we will get 4 times. Here, 8 times, 24 will be 12 times. Again, in 4 table we will get 1 time, 2 times, 3 times. So the total LCM will be 2 4s are 8. 8 2s are 16, 16 3s are 48. So 48 divided by 8, nothing but 6. So 1 into 6, 6 minus 48 divided by 16, that is 3 times. So 3 into 1, 3 minus 48 divided by 24, that is 2 times. So the answer will be 6 minus 5 by 48. That is, Hari's one day's work is 1 by 48. So in one day he can do 1 by 48th part of the work. So in how many days he can complete, means simply reciprocal the answer. So he can complete the total work in 48 days. That is, 1 by 48 reciprocal is 48 by 1. So simply in 48 days he can complete the work. So option A is correct. See the next question. On a toss of 2 dice, A throws a total of 5, then the probability that he will throw 5 before he throws 7 is. That means a person A is throwing 2 dice. So 2 dice are there, die 1 and die 2. So when he throws these 2 dice, the sum of the both dice should be 5. Will be our first case, and the sum should be 7 is our second case. Why we are considering these both cases means, in the question they have asked, A throws a total of 5. Okay. Then the probability that he will throw another 5 before he throws 7. Here he have also mentioned sum 7. So we will consider both the cases. The first, to get the sum 5. To get sum 5, if die 1 number is 1. Okay, before going into it, what are the numbers that are on the die? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 numbers will be there. So if die 1 has 1 number after throwing, what will be the number on die 2? It will be 4. So that 1 plus 4 is equals to 5. Now immediately write the reciprocal of those. 4, 1. Next, while considering 2, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. 3 plus 2 equals to 5. Next, going into 3, already we have written with 3, so go into 4, we have already written with 4, 1, 1, 4. When going into 5, it is greater than, if we are writing 5 here, we should at least write 1 or 2 or 3 or anything. So 5 plus anything will be greater than 5, it will not be equals to 5, so stop it up to here. So 1, 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3 and 2. So total, how many throws will be there? Total 4 chances are there to get the sum as 5. This first case chance, second chance, third chance, fourth chance. So total 4 chances. Out of how many? On a die we have 6 possibilities. For 2 dice we will have 6 square. Okay, so 4 by 6 square means 4 by 36 chances are there to get the sum of both dice as 5. The second case is to get the sum as 7. So on to get the chance as 7, first case, if on die 1 we have 1, on die 2 we will get, to get a sum of 7, 6. 1 plus 6 is 7. Similarly, 6 plus 1 is also equal to 7. Similarly, when die 1 shows 2, what should be the number on die 2? It should be 5. So that 2 plus 5 equals to 7. 5 plus 2 is also equal to 7. Similarly with 3, 4, 4 and 3. Similarly with 5, we have already written. With 6 also we have already written. So how many chances are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total here we have 6 chances. to get a sum of 7. 6 by total number of chances, that is 6 square, 36. Because we are using 2 dice, we will write 6 square. If we are using 10 dice, we will write 6 power 10. That means 6 power n is our general formula. Now they asked in the question, the probability that he will throw 5 before 7. So what is our favorable event? It is favorable event is the sum should be 5. So what is our favorable event? 4 by 36 is our favorable event. So probability is equal to favorable event 4 by 36 by total number of events. What are the events? Sum should be 7 and sum should be 5. So sum should be 5 and 7 are our total events. So for 5, what is the favorable event here? 4 by 36. For sum should be 7, it is 6 by 36. That is nothing but equal to 4 by 36 divided by 10 by 36. 4, 4 gets cancelled and we will get 4 by 10. So in order to get percentage, we will multiply it with 100. So 0, 0 gets cancelled and the final answer is 40%. So option A is correct. So the probability that he will throw another 5 before he throws 7 is 40%, because they asked answer in percentages, that's why I multiplied with 100. If they simply asked the probability, write down 4 by 10, that is nothing but equal to 2.5 is our probability. See the next question here. In 2003, there are 28 days in February and there are 365 days in a year. In 2004, there are 29 days in February and 360 days in this year. Why? Because we all knew that 2004 is a leap year. So here they asked, if the date March 11, 2003 is a Tuesday, which of the following would be the day of March 11, 2004? Simply the next year. Basically, if a date of a year, if it is Monday, in the next year, the same date will be Tuesday. But when it comes to leap year, a normal year is turned into leap year, what happens? The day will be increased by 1. So if it is Monday in this year, the next leap year it will be Wednesday. That means it will skip Tuesday and it will move to Wednesday. So we should add plus 1 day. So here in the question, March 11, 2003 is Tuesday. Okay? March 11, 2003 is Tuesday and March 11, 2004 they have asked. So Tuesday will be skipped by 1 day. Tuesday after Wednesday, Wednesday will be skipped and the answer will be Thursday. So Tuesday in 2003 and it will be Thursday in 2004. So answer is Thursday, option C. See the next question here. The average marks of A, B, C is 48. So three students are there, A, B, C, their average marks are 48. If D joins, average becomes 47. E has 3 more marks than D. Average marks of B, C, D is 48. Find the marks of A. So first write down the equations. Average marks are A, B, C, D. What is the average formula? Average marks of A, B, C. What is the average formula? Sum of marks divided by total number of persons. So A plus B plus C is marks divided by 3, because 3 persons are there, is equal to 48. That implies A plus B plus C is equal to 48 into 3. It is nothing but 144. Okay. Now the sum of marks of A, B, C are 144. Now D joins and the average becomes 47. That means A plus B plus C plus D. So D joins, so total 4 persons, the average becomes now 47. That implies A plus B plus C plus D is equal to 47 into 4. It becomes 188. 47 into 4. Now we already know what is A plus B plus C. That is nothing but 144. So substitute here, 144 plus D is equal to 188. Now D is equal to 188 minus 144. D is equals to 44. So the marks of D is 44. Next one, they have given that E has 3 more marks than D. So So E marks is equal to 3 plus marks obtained by 3. So we already knew the D marks, that is 44. Now simply add 3 to it. So E marks is equal to 3 plus 44, that is nothing but equals to 47. Okay. E has 3 more marks. So 44 plus 3, that is nothing but equal to 47. So E marks is equal to 47 marks. The average marks of B, C, D, E is 48. So average marks of B plus C plus D plus E, since 4 students divided by 4 is 48. That implies B plus C, we know D marks, that is 44. We also knew E marks, that is 47, is equal to 48 into 4. What is 48 into 4? 32, 16, 17, 18, 19. This is 192. 44 plus 7, this is 91. Okay, so we got B plus C, that from here we can write B plus C equal to 192 minus 91, that is nothing but equals to 101 marks. That means B plus C's mark sum is 101. Now we have to find A marks. Consider this equation. Now A plus B plus C, we already knew what is B plus C, so substitute in place of B plus C is equal to 101. So A plus 101 is equal to 144. A is equal to 144 minus 101, that is simply equals to 43 marks. So the total marks obtained by A is nothing but 43. So here our option B, 43, is correct.